Time now for Utah's most accurate forecast with Alana Brophy, weather rate certified 9 years in a row.
Welcome back on this Wednesday. Need a breather? Let's do it in the weather. We've got clear skies down there in Washington City, which is nice to see. Plenty of sunshine and temperatures warming into the 50s throughout the St. George area. And we've got that warmth that wants to hold steady. We look at Lake Mountain and sometimes we'll see haze when we've got high pressure in control. But luckily, yesterday and into today, we've seen those clear skies after that disturbance came through yesterday morning, which means we get a gorgeous view. Snow on top of the mountains there, but we do have a little bit of cloud cover out there. Temperatures are in the 20s in Cache Valley. We're seeing them make it into the mid-30s in Ogden, 40 in Salt Lake, so we warmed up, so that's a good indicator that haze not holding steady in Salt Lake County just yet. It will continue to build. 34 in Provo, 50s down there in St. George at this hour. As we get through the next couple of days, we will see air quality impacted because of the fact we've got that high pressure and we have a weak storm pattern that's going to be moving ahead. As we look at those numbers on the backside of the Wasatch, 20s and 30s, freezing in Heber, just above that in Morgan, freezing in Tooele, and a mix of upper 30s and low 40s throughout Salt Lake and Utah County. Satellite shows us how the clouds starting to increase and move on in. We get a weak disturbance that's going to track on through for tomorrow. It will bring an increase in clouds, but on top of that, maybe an isolated light mountain snow shower. As we watch the core of that moisture stay to our north tonight, clouds will continue to build as that system gets a little closer. Some patchy fog could be out there in some of our stubborn valleys. There's that front going to just graze northern Utah, not really our storm system. It's a little further to the north. High pressure still in control there, but we're active in the Pacific Northwest. Very on target with La Nina. The Pacific Northwest will continue to get some wet weather. As we get into Friday, later in the day, we'll see clouds as well as rain and snow showers starting to move on in. It will start as rain and switch to snow as a cold front will come on through that will linger into Saturday morning. And that's the best chance of our next precipitation. Futurecast gives us the timeline on it so we know exactly when it's going to move on through. That's pinpoint, that high pressure staying in control. Clouds coming on through. Here we are at midnight. Those clouds will stick around into tomorrow. Partly cloudy skies expected. That weak system grazes the northern portion of the state. High pressure tries to set up, but this storm system says no thanks. By 5 o'clock, there's that mixed bag of moisture for the Wasatch Front, that system impacting northern Utah Friday evening. That will continue. We get a break and then into Friday night and early Saturday morning. We have the potential for some snow showers. Accumulations will be very light once again, just not tapping in to those juicy storms that we typically see. Dry pattern set up after that. For tomorrow, we do expect several northern Utah areas to hit that moderate air quality group. So heads up there, the haze is going to build back. You'll probably see it pretty easily. 30s and 40s for tomorrow, 36 in Price. The vernal area in the Uinta Basin going to be cold, 43 in Cedar City, 50s in St. George. We'll hold on to that trend for the next couple of days. Dry conditions down there in Washington County. A few more clouds Friday and Sunday. Some breezy conditions Saturday and Sunday as that front comes through and delivers some northerly winds. There's the Wasatch Front with the chance of those snow showers. Again, Friday evening, we're going to see some mixed precipitation coming in late in the day that will linger into Saturday morning. And we'd start to dry out with a ridge of high pressure setting up shop and a quieter pattern taking hold. Before you go, don't forget to download the ABC4 weather app on your smart device. Now, we'll be right back.